Respected all, a very good evening to all the dignitaries, guests, participants in the inaugural session of the Crossroad Talk series started by Delhi School of Business as an initiative for the youngsters of today pursuing various courses and desirous of choosing a career path in different fields who find themselves at the crossroads where decision making for them is not so easy. COVID-19 and its consequences have made things more complex, and hence these youngsters are confused between different career paths, career apprehensions about the possibilities available to them. They are quite perplexed with the challenges they see and the negativity they hear around. The Crossroad Talk series launched at Delhi School of Business is an effort in the right direction to address all these concerns around youngsters and shall try to answer their queries and apprehensions. We further have a series of talk to be delivered by a few eminent experts from various parts of life. Today, we are fortunate to have with us the CEO and co-founder People Labs as an eminent guest speaker. I, on behalf of Delhi School of Business, extend a very warm welcome to Mr. Subrat Kumar and all the participants joining us for the live session today. I further extend my heartiest and a very warm welcome to our Honorable Chairman Sir, Dr. H.C. Watts, Vice Chairman Sir, Shri Sunit Watts, Shri Vineet Watts Sir, and Director of Delhi School of Business, Dr. Rajiv R. Thakur, along with all the chairpersons and deans of WIPS, faculty of DSB, and all the other esteemed members present at the session amongst us. Before proceeding further ahead, I would want you to know that Mr. Subrat Kumar is the CEO and co-founder of People Labs Private Limited, a leading name now in the area of training, research, and consulting. An MBA from MDI, Gurgaon, he has worked as a trainee with various public sectors and many leading B schools across the country. He has trained close to 25,000 participants across hierarchy and known for his workshops on team building, motivation, capability building, and leadership. He has also published internationally with his case study on IR practices in CNH being published in Richard Ivey School of Business Case Center. He has been the lead researcher for NHRDNB School Ranking Survey since its inception, and his areas of interest include leadership and customer centricity. With his experience of being closely connected to the industry and educational institutions, I request Mr. Subrat Kumar Sir to enlighten us all on the career opportunities and challenges in the post-pandemic placements. Sir.
Thank you so much for such a great welcome. Honorable Chairman, Vice Chairman of the Institute, Rajiv Thakur Sir. I could also see somewhere Professor Ratan Sharma Sir also here. At least with two of you, my association goes long back, and I'm thankful to the entire team for inviting me over here. First of all, let me tell you something very interesting. I'm very happy being here, and you know why. I'm happy being here because at least I can see the faces over here. A lot of places where I go and interact with kids in this pandemic and post-pandemic times, whatever you say, all that I see is black boxes. You know, and the black boxes are so deceptive that you never know that actually there is a person or not. And most of the times, I'm pretty sure most of you would have done also that, you know, sir, there is a slight bandwidth issue and that is why my video is not working. And then you are calmly, whether you are there or not, no one actually knows. So on that note, I'm pretty happy as I start this discussion with you people that I can see the faces and I can see young, bright faces over here. My compliments to all the organizers and the students also. You definitely deserve a round of applause from all of us. Because in pandemic times, this is the minimum professional behavior which is expected from students. You know, what brings me over here and perhaps what I'm going to share with you at the very outset, let me tell you, I'm not going to keep it a monologue. I hope most of you understand Hindi. I'm not going to speak in Hindi, but there may be a few sentences here or there which I may speak in Hindi. So let me tell you, मैं यहाँ पे ज्ञान देने नहीं आया हूँ. I don't have a presentation. You know, my role model, Padmashri Dr. Pritam Singh always used to say that power corrupts, PowerPoint corrupts absolutely. So the moment you have a PowerPoint presentation, you are all, you know, focused on, array, 6 slides done, 12 more to go, there is only this much time, there is only that much time. And you're obsessed more with how many slides are left rather than what you're going to, you know, interact and talk about. So as I said, let's keep it a dialogue. And you know, that is the way each one of us can maximize our takeaways from this interaction. I have no PowerPoint. I have no bullets written over here on some chit of paper, which I'll be referring to. And let's turn the tables now. At the end of the day, tell me whose placements are at stake, mine or yours? Whenever you want to say, you can unmute yourself. Whose placements are at stake? My, your faculties, your directors, your chairpersons, or it is of your students? If you have problem in unmuting, you can always type. I would love to listen to you. Students, ours, we... ours. So who should be worried about what to do? Students, we. But do I tell you a very brutal fact? And I'm saying here with all due humility, and I'm saying it here with all due responsibility. You know who are the most bichara people in B school fraternity? The most bichara people in the B school fraternity are the placement chair and the director. I'm telling you honestly. Because first they run after the companies. Then they finally somehow get them to campus. And then the students will show all kind of tantrums. And then the company will fire them. And then the only thing which they keep on doing is saying, sorry. You know these kids. My question to you is, should it actually be like that? The reality is it should not. We are talking about opportunities post-pandemic. Let me take you a little back. Can anyone tell me which year was the subprime crisis? Do you remember?
2008.
And which year placements were impacted because of subprime crisis?
So following that year, 9 and 10.
2009 was the worst impacted year. Please go to Google and do a very basic fundamental search. 2009 B school placements. You know what the results show? And I can give you an exact number. I can tell you what B schools claim. I don't go by that. But the reality was, except for I'm Ahmedabad and I'm Bangalore, none of the B schools, including I'm Calcutta, could complete its placement on the day of convocation. IIM Kolkata, 40 students were unplaced on the day of convocation. I'm not getting into who got placed in, you know, April, May, June, July. I'm not going into that. I'm just telling you on the day of convocation. 40 students were unplaced at IIM Kolkata. And if this was the scene of IIM Kolkata, you can very well imagine what would have happened. You get the point which I'm trying to share? I'm just giving you a historical perspective. Come at 2020, tell me what is the GDP rate expected to be this year? What is the GDP growth expected this year?
11.2.
That's for the next year, dear. 11.2 is expected to be in 21-22. What is the GDP expected to be in 2020-2021?
8.8.
That's definitely not right. My first question is, will it grow or will it degrow?
It will degrow.
It will degrow, right? So whatever the growth rate is, it is definitely less than 0%. If the GDP rate is less than 0%, then tell me, will the jobs in market increase or will the jobs in market shrink?
Shrink.
It shrinks.
It will shrink. Agreed. Do you also agree that a biggest outcome, I'm not getting into right or wrong, but one of the biggest outcome of this pandemic has been that automation and digitization has increased manifold? Do you agree?
Definitely, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes?
Definitely.
I'm pretty sure, at least I can talk about me. Before the lockdown, I had never heard about Zoom. I do not know if any one of you had heard. I'm pretty sure some might have, but at least I had not heard about Zoom. Right? Definitely Skype, but not Zoom. Today, to some extent, our life is incomplete without Zoom. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, digitization and automation, because of them, again, the jobs will increase or decrease?
Decrease.
And let me also share at the very outset, I don't want to, present a very dark picture to you people. I don't want to do that. But I'm just talking on the basis of facts and helping you realize that this is what the reality is. Because a bigger problem, whenever I have interacted with corporates, the bigger problem what the corporates are facing today. The B school graduates come and on day one, they declare we have arrived. I am the Philip Kotler. I am the Michael Porter. Whatever I say is the Brahma Vakya. And the CEO said, bhai, kam se kam 30 saal laga ke yahan pe pahuncha, mujhe thodi izzat to de do. Arre sir, aapko pata hi nahi hai, main batata hu hota kaise hai. Aur kisi ne agar aapko daant diya, तो आप ऐसे बच्चे हो कि आप दिल पे लगा के बैठ जाओगे, बताओ यार आज तक तो पापा मम्मी और टीचर सब लोगों ने कहा मैं कितना राजा बच्चा हूं, और किसी ने डांट दिया कि मैं तो गधा हूं. द आयरनी इज यू आर सच पैम्पर्ड लॉट. डोंट माइंड माई सेइंग दिस. 90% ऑफ यू आर सच अ पैम्पर्ड लॉट. यू हैव बीन ब्रॉट अप बाय हेलीकॉप्टर पेरेंट्स, ऑलवेज ओवर यू. Overprotective. Now, what has happened? No one has told you the reality, bhai. Boss, you need to improve. And all of a sudden, when you go to job and someone says that, you say, boss, kuch to gadbad hai. However, the reality is after 2 years, you realize ki gadbad ab nahi hai, gadbad pehle thi. Ab to mujhe vastvikta logon ne bata diya. That is what the reality is. Coming back to my pointers. GDP is going to decrease, therefore jobs will come down. Automation and digitization is increasing, therefore jobs will come down. Am I right? So for example, if I tell you, and I'm going to write that, and I strongly feel, except for a very handful of students, HR specialization as a only specialization, if it is a dual, it is great. But HR specialization as the sole specialization should be banned in many colleges. Why am I saying so? Because due to automation, a lot of HR jobs have come down, right? Earlier, I can tell you, and my own cousin started his career like this. He's an MBA from XISS. He joined TCS. You know what was his first assignment? His first assignment in Delhi office, PTI office was, that tomorrow we have a flight to somewhere in Bhopal, an engineering college. We are going to pick kids from there. Please ensure that 350 question sets are printed, stapled, and neatly bundled into groups of 50. This was how a XISS HR graduate started. Today, do the companies conduct a pen and paper test or it is online test?
Online test.
Would you need a person to do that job?
No, sir.
What is happening? No, I'm talking just again. I'm repeating. I'm not saying HR plus something else. I'm saying only HR. These schools need to have a relook. And the reason I'm sharing this is a lot of you who have got HR specialization. We are talking on 28th of January. Take time till Valentine's Day. another 15-16 days. On 14th February, please decide that what are your chances of landing up with an HR job. If the chances are high landing up with an HR job, please go for HR. If not, you need to have a backup. What is your backup you need to look into? And there should be clarity in your head. I'm not talking about others. Due to this pandemic, do you also realize that new skills have become relevant?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In one of my talk shows, I invited a lady who is based out of Facebook, Singapore. She heads the emerging markets division for Facebook and Supreet Kaur. And she was sharing with me that, Subrat, you know, now digital literacy is not a luxury. It is not a necessity. It is now a fundamental right. If you are not digitally literate, you don't have fundamental right to ask for a job. Such is the situation. Do we agree? Yes or no?
Definitely, sir.
Yes, sir.
And digital literacy, let me tell you, does not mean that how frequently you change your DPs and how interesting your stories are at Instagram. You know, I know Facebook is dead, so I'm not going to say that, or your WhatsApp, whatever it is. It essentially means how well versed you are with new technology. Make sense? A lot of, you know, even hardcore traditional companies. Again, I take example of Asian Paints. Yesterday only I was taking a training session for their new joinees who have joined on the technical side. The amount of digitization and the amount of automation which they have done, that is unparalleled. What that essentially means is you need to have new set of competencies to move ahead in the career. I will spend 5 minutes on what are those competencies. But till this point, if you have any question, I will be happy to answer that. Any question?
So my name is Shashan Singhal. I have one question. So as you said that most of the jobs in HR are getting automated, I have a bit doubt and I have a bit different opinion there.
Sure.
Because what I think is HR is a field where your human skills matters a lot, isn't it? For instance, when we are making performance appraisal or when we are assessing the training needs, how well we talk to people, how much we can empathize with people. These things always comes in picture. So how is it getting automated? And I just want to know your views on it, sir.
I'll tell you, Shashant, I will give you live examples of two companies. One is a Fortune 500 company called ADP, Automatic Data Processing, right? Its Fortune 500 rank is 291 or something. And the other company is a hardcore, you know, desi company. Its name is Annapurna Microfinance Private Limited. Both their HR heads, in one of the trainings which I was co-delivering with them, you know what they told? They said, I don't know what is the KPI of my team, but I know what is my KPI. And my KPI is that I have to reduce my team strength by 80%. They have said it. They have said it upfront in front of their team members. You talked about performance appraisal, right? It is completely automated. You talk about recruitment. It is 50% automated. So earlier, if you needed so many people, you don't need so many people. And a lot of companies are outsourcing it. We are in that business, we know. Because they don't need so many people. Na? They just get the experts. They think that my hiring season is for 3 months. Why should I pay an employee for 12 months? I will just outsource it. My work is getting done. Why should I pay it? These are the changes which are happening. I am saying that the reduction in number of jobs in HR is much higher than other specializations. I never intend to say that HR will not exist. I never intend to say that HR will disappear. All that I'm trying to tell you, and what will happen, you need to also appreciate. See, when the number of jobs in HR will decrease, who will be the first casualty? Obviously, lower ranked kids, yes or no?
the newcomers.
Newcomers, that is how it is. That was the point which I wanted to share. I don't want to again, you know, portray a scary picture, but that is where the reality is.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Shiva.
Sir, actually, I wanted to ask one thing. Like you told about that, it can be automated. But given the scenarios like in HR, like we need to do performance appraisal or maybe take a decision on the policy also. So that requires, and it may be like given the scenarios, laws are there that need to be done and we need to follow the laws. But sometimes we need to also take some human skills are also required, like the emotional or the other things also are required in order to make some decisions in special circumstances. So how can they be automated?
Shivam, when in 1980s, the computers came, the professors across the country had gone on strike saying that the computers will take away all the jobs. Right? Which did not happen.
Yes.
But what has definitely happened, that a lot of clerical jobs have been automated and you do not need the same set of people which were earlier needed. Today, anyone can, today, where do you write more? On a notebook, or when I'm saying notebook, I'm talking about pen and paper notebook, or on laptop?
Laptop.
That's it. I'm going back to those days, and perhaps Rajiv sir can echo this, where, you know, getting your dissertation printed in itself was a challenge. There were specific people who will, you know, get the soft copy, you will get that in floppy disk, and then the same will be printed, everything. Today, are we dependent on anyone? No, we are not. Right? So what you are talking about, EQ and everything, that's correct. That's why I'm saying it's not coming down to zero. But what I'm trying to help you understand, that if there were 100 jobs earlier, those 100 have now become 70, those 100 have now become 60. That is where the challenge is. And a lot of companies are now saying that my HR people also should understand business. That is why if you have HR plus one more specialization, you are better placed than, you know, putting all your eggs in one basket of HR. That is what the reality as of now, at least for campus placements, is. And across the B schools, I have been listening to this. And it's not about your, I can name, you know, the best of B schools who do not have a separate HR specialization. Ford School of Management has this challenge. They cannot place their, you know, HR kids in HR roles. They have to ask them to go for a sales job. That's a reality. I'm taking the name of the institute. It's nothing hidden. Because job nahi hai to kya karoge? Bolo, either you leave the institute without a job, or at least you have something to leave now, and then you can decide on your career, in your career where you want to go. Clear? May I move ahead now? I will give you my mantra of 5 C's. When I talk about skills, there are 5 C's. C1 is curiosity. Curiosity about what? Curiosity about anything, just anything. Because if you are curious, that tells me that you have a learning attitude and you have a learning ability. If you are not curious, the only way you are going is down, 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 and down. Is first C clear? First C is curiosity. What is the second C? Connectedness. What do I mean by connectedness? If you have to take one sentence from our discussion today, that is, your network is your net worth. I say it, this is my takia kalam wherever I go. Your network is your net worth. Network with whom? Network with anyone whom you meet. Be it your batchmates, be it your seniors, be it your juniors, be it your professors, be it, you know, the professionals who come and interact with you people. But then you also need to learn the art of networking. You know, I will get 100 of LinkedIn requests. Tell me, why should I accept? So this session gets over. 25 of you, I'm just assuming, send me a LinkedIn request. Tell me, why should I accept your request? Is that connect? Is that networking? Is that connectivity? And most of you, if I will check, you have not posted anything on your LinkedIn profile for last 7 months. Except for writing interested, commenting for better reach. These are the, again, two takia kalams, which you will see in plenty in, LinkedIn nowadays. Have you written any post? No. Have you written any article? No. Is your profile updated? No. When you are sending me a LinkedIn request, will you even just politely introduce yourself? Who you are? Why do you want to connect? No. Just like, acha sun, aaj aaya tha ek Subrat Kumar naam ka aadmi. LinkedIn pe ja, usko khoj, milta hai, to usko kar de. Even if I accept, what benefit does this network bring to you? Tell me that. Does it bring any network? Does it bring any benefit to you? What will happen? Then you will send me a good afternoon, sir. It's a good afternoon. It was a pleasure interacting with you. Thank you. And then you will come to the mudda. Sir, is there an opportunity in your organization? Or can you help? Can you refer me somewhere? Aap ho kaun? Ek dusre ko humne jana hi nahi abhi. And then you will say that get me a job. And if I will not respond, then you will feel bad. यार जब आया था तब तो बड़ी बड़ी बातें कर रहा था, देखो लेकिन हमने लिख के भेजा, उसने जवाब भी नहीं दिया. यार कंसीडर माय सिचुएशन आल्सो, हाउ मेनी पीपल विल आई जस्ट कीप ऑन रेस्पॉन्डिंग नो 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 नो. एंड यू हैव सच अ लैक ऑफ पेशेंस कि इफ आई डोंट रिप्लाई टू योर मैसेज इन, एटलीस्ट इट हैपेंस ओवर व्हाट्सएप, इफ आई डोंट रिप्लाई टू योर मैसेज इन 5 मिनट्स, देन यू ऑल्सो सेंड मी क्वेश्चन मार्क 3 times. अरे भाई, यू वेर फ्री, यू सेंट मी अ मैसेज. When I will get free, I will reply to you, right? I'm not obliged to reply to you. And when I'm saying I am referring to anyone, anyone I'm talking about. Please understand that. I'm an MDI graduate. I can tell you, in my entrepreneurial journey, my professors have played an amazing role. Amazing role. I acknowledge that. But do you actually, you know, connect with your faculty in that manner? Unfortunately, many a times what I see, and I'm not saying you do it, I'm not saying this about your B school, but a lot of times I have seen that the faculty-student relation has now been restricted to what? Transaction. Aapki class mein aa gaye na? Paper de diya na? Fees time pe chali gayi na? Ab isse jyada mere se umeed kar rahe ho, to ye aapki galti hai. They have no problem. You will leave. But इससे ज्यादा अगर आप उनसे भी expect कर रहे हो तो ये आपकी गलती है. Do you realize what I'm trying to say? You never know who amongst you is going to rise very fast in your corporate career. The reality for many of the, you know, kids nowadays is you don't even know your batchmates. Forget senior, junior. तुम्हें batchmate तुम क्या तुम्हारे साथ है? 10 लोगों का अपना group है. वही सड़े हुए चुटकुले सुनाओगे, वही सड़े हुए 2 लोगों के बारे में कुछ, यू नो, यू विल पास कपल ऑफ चीप कमेंट्स, मोस्ट ऑफ विच विल बी अनपार्लियामेंट्री, एंड देन यू विल लाफ इट अलाउड, एंड देन यू विल गो टू द सेम, यू नो, मूर्थल ढाबाज, एंड देन यू विल क्लिक एंड, यू नो, रॉक स्टार एंड दिस एंड दैट, ऑल ऑफ दैट इज ग्रेट, बट डोंट यू थिंक योर नेटवर्क इज बियॉन्ड दोस 10 पीपल? यस और नो? बट एम आई रॉन्ग इफ आई से दैट मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर गिल्टी ऑफ just confining yourself to only those set of people? Am I wrong? I hope you have got the meaning of the second C which I talked about. What was second C? You can unmute yourself and say. I started with curiosity. The second C was connectedness, wherein I talked about networking in the real sense. What is the third C? Core competency. What core competency do you bring to the table for me? Sir, I am an MBA graduate, so? Aapse main pooch lo, what are 4 P's? Kuch to aise hote hain jo usi mein jhool jaate hain. I have seen kids who have applied for banking job and I ask them a simple question, what is a DMAT account? Sir, I am actually from marketing. Main unse kehta hu, to beta apne apply to banking job ke liye kiya hai na. But sir, I read that, you know, the title is relationship manager. I said, sir, to relationship manager ke niche ka bhi aapne padha tha kya? Wo to padha hi nahi. Maine kaha beta isme sales likha. What will you sell in a banking company industry? You will sell banking product ya aap sabun tel bechoge? Mujhe pehle ye batao. You will sell the product of the company only. Am I right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in that case, you must know what is your core competency. What do you bring on table? If you don't bring anything on table, why should I waste my time with you? I will say, oh, thank you so much. Mile, bahut achha laga. Thank you very much. Bye, bye, bye. On a lighter note, let me give you a very, and my apologies if anyone feels bad. But on a lighter note, let me give you an example. What happens in your interviews? Most of you will get married in next 5 years, right? Whenever you decide to get married, you come out with a set of checklist which you will look in other person. It can be about education, it can be about family, it can be about what is the appearance of the person, it can be about hobbies, it can be about likes, dislikes. If you believe in religion, it may be astrology. Now, if you have got a checklist of 7 points, very soon you realize that you will not get anyone with all 7 ticked. Because 7 to aapke bhi tick nahi hai na bhai. Dusre ke checklist mein aap bhi to 7 tick nahi kara pa rahe ho na. Then what will you say? These are mandatory. At least 4 ticks should be there, out of which these are mandatory. And then I will move ahead and I will consider whether I get married or not. Consider a scenario when someone walks up to you and says, Hi, I am Rahul. Naam to suna hi hoga. Will you marry me? What would be your reply? Tell me, what would be your reply?
So what can I do? That will be our reply.
Get lost in whatever politically correct word you want to say. That is what you will say. Now take yourself to the interview room. Interviewer has also got a checklist. And the interviewer starts. पर अपने दिल पे हाथ रख के कहो आप में से बहुत लोग ना इतनी प्रिपरेशन के साथ जाते हो इंटरव्यू में जहां पे आप कहते हो आई एम राहुल नाम तो सुना होगा इंटरव्यू से नो और जो आपने उसको कहा वो इंटरव्यूअर आपको कह देता है गेट लॉस्ट एंड देन यू मूव आउट व्हाट इज योर कोर कॉम्पिटेंसी विच यू ब्रिंग टू द टेबल इज इट क्लियर सो द थर्ड सी ऑफ कोर कॉम्पिटेंसी आई होप दैट इज क्लियर विथ यू
यस सर
What yes, is the fourth sir. One? Communication. How well you are in communicating. And trust me, I stay very near to a private hospital in Noida. Kai bar interviews mein ya interactions mein ya jab mails exchange hoti hain, kuch bachche jaise English likhte ya bolte hain, I may need to see a cardiologist at any point of time. Bachchon, U ki spelling Y-O-U hoti hai. Tum sirf U likh ke bhej dete ho, toh main tumhara batchmate nahi hu. Right? Where? W-R. Kehta hun, Prabhu, thoda sa samajh jao, what is the difference between the two? All those from West UP and Haryana, let me tell you, please don't mind my saying this. But you have a very clear cut takiya kalam. Sir, I belong from. Aur jyada khush hote ho to keh dete ho, I belongs from. Main kehta hu ek minute ruk jao zara. Pehle I belongs ya I belong? Nahi sir, I belong. Maine kaha from ya to? So to. But, and this is, you know, I'm just taking these examples because I have seen this for, it is not about again stereotyping anyone. I come from Bihar here. I spent a lot of time in Uttar Pradesh and Uttaranchal. When I first came to Uttaranchal for my engineering, mere ko sha aur sa ke beech mein antar hi nahi pata tha. Mere ko ra aur da ke beech mein antar hi nahi pata tha. Mujhe ragging mein logon ne kaha, "Acha bolo, ghoda sadak par padak padak dauda." And I said, "Ghoda sadak par padak padak dauda." Everyone is laughing off. I said, "Why the hell are you laughing?" Then someone told, "Bhai, ra aur da alag alag hote hain." I said, "Acha." That was a learning for me. Similarly, for you also, I'm just telling that these are, you know, a very, because there's a first sentence which you will say, I belong from. समझ गया कि बॉस अभी लोचा. What was the fourth C which I talked about?
Communication.
And the fifth C, now let me tell you, is contextual. Problem with most of the kids, and don't mind my saying this, आप लोगों को ना, मैं देखो न्यूज़पेपर कहना तो पढ़ो, ये मैंने कहना 3 साल पहले छोड़ दिया. मैं कहता हूं कम से कम इन शॉर्ट्स नाम का कुछ आता है, उसी से पढ़ लो यार. कम से कम ट्विटर पे जाओ तो एक बार थोड़ा देख लो कि कुछ पढ़े लिखे लोग जो बोल रहे हैं वो भी एक बार देख लो. दैट इज दैट एड्स टू यू. व्हाई आई एम सेइंग बीइंग कॉन्टेक्चुअल, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल से अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स ऑन सोशल मीडिया अबाउट एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग. सम ऑफ यू ऑल्सो वुड हैव रिटन आइदर फॉर और अगेंस्ट व्हाटएवर फार्मर एजिटेशन इज गोइंग ऑन. मैं सच्ची बात बताता हूं कि यहाँ पे 2% भी लोग ऐसे नहीं होंगे जिन्होंने एक्चुअली फार्मर्स लॉ पढ़ा होगा. राइट, आई स्टैंड बाय हु आर, एक तरफ से होगा आई स्टैंड बाय, दूसरे हु आर दिस फार्मर्स, दे कैन नॉट बी फार्मर्स. दोनों से पूछो कि तुमने क्या पढ़ा है तो दोनों ने कुछ नहीं पढ़ा होगा. आर यू गेटिंग द पॉइंट व्हिच आई एम ट्राइंग टू शेयर विद यू?
यस सर.
The point which I'm trying to share with you is that you need to be contextual. चीजें पढ़ो. उसे पता है सबसे बड़ा फायदा क्या होता है? The biggest benefit is आप सभ्य समाज में उठने बैठने और बात करने लायक हो जाते हो. You have something to talk in an elite society, in an elite group of people, you can talk something meaningful, you can talk something contextual. Otherwise, kab tak baat karoge? Kya lagta hai, Alia aur Ranveer finally kar lenge ya Ranveer fir wahi karega jaisa usne pehle waliyon ke saath kiya hai? Jab tak graduation mein the, tab tak in baaton ka ek apna samay tha. All of us have enjoyed. It's not like that I am giving this gyan, I have been holier than thou. All of us have done, but the point which I'm trying to share, now you are in which? You are in your post-graduation, right? You are in a professional program of MBA. So at least try to be contextual. If someone asks you, so I can tell you one story. When I went to a college in Greater Noida and I asked the kids, tell me who's the finance minister of India? And a kid said, "Bade jor se kaha, Pranab Mukherjee." और उस समय प्रणव मुखर्जी प्रेसिडेंट थे. तो मैंने उस बच्चे को कहा, बच्चे मुझे इस बात का दुख नहीं है कि तुम्हें फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर नहीं पता है, मुझे इस बात का ज्यादा दुख है कि तुम्हें प्रेसिडेंट भी नहीं पता है. राइट, फॉर मेनी किड्स एचआरडी मिनिस्टर इज स्टिल कपिल सिब्बल. बेचारे का बंगला भी छिन गया दिल्ली का और तुम लोग अभी भी उसको एचआरडी मिनिस्टर बनाए रखे हो. It's not what I am saying. This is what my experience is saying. So therefore, the fifth point which I talked about was being contextual. I'm going to spend another few minutes, regarding sectors, which sectors will pick up. But again, before I move there, if you have any questions, I will be happy to take them up. Anything anyone wants to ask, go ahead.
Sir, you talked about core competency. Most of the times it is that a person is unsure about his or her core competency. I'm not taking my example. I know what my core competency is, but it is a very common phenomenon that people don't know at what they excel. So how do we identify one's core competency?
There are 3 aspects of your core competency. It is an ask formula. A for attitude, 2 for skills, 3 for knowledge. A for attitude, S for skills, and K for knowledge. You know what is compromised the most? Knowledge. हमें लगता है कि यार हम इंग्लिश बोल लेते हैं बस हो गया खत्म, अब सारी नौकरियां हमारी. You don't get jobs that way. And, you know, when I talked about communication, let me tell you, all of us have come from different backgrounds. Some of you would have been educated in, you know, English medium schools throughout. Some of you might not have been. But if you have not been educated and you feel that your communication is a weakness, if others are spending 2 hours on your communication, you spend 6 hours on your communication, because without communication, you're not going to get a job. Let's be clear about it. एक लेवल से नीचे अगर आपकी कम्युनिकेशन स्किल है, आपको नौकरी नहीं मिलेगी, खत्म. दैट्स इट. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन एनीवन? वी आर गुड टू मूव अहेड.
यस सर.
यस सर.
यस सर.
सो इफ यू लुक इन फॉर योर बैच, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सेकंड ईयर kids, if I'm talking about your badge, the sector which you must tap, target, and look for in whichever way best possible, one is banking and financial sector. That sector is doing pretty well. Insurance sector is also growing very fast. NBFCs are doing pretty well. Banks are doing pretty well. They're hiring in good numbers. That is a sector which you must target. However, let me also tell you the reality. In this sector, the jobs which you will get will be of anything between 3.75 lakh to 4.75 lakh. This is the package which they are offering across campuses. If you feel it is too less, you may leave that. But again, I'm just talking from the volume of offers which this sector will be coming up. That is going to be maximum. Second, if you ask... The second sector is going to be the online space. In online space, again, if you talk about edutech will have a lot of openings coming. But let me caution you against one thing. Edutech is going through the same phase through which e-commerce was going through some 6-7 years ago. You remember the Snap deals of the world? So there was a Snap deal, Flipkart, Jabong, Mintra, Kirana Wala, Padosi Wala, Padosi Kirana, all things, whatever you could think of, they were there. Now, what happened that most of them actually had to close the business. Right? Today, we have an Amazon, we have a Flipkart, and then we have a Mintra in a different form. Jabong and all those have been acquired. Snapdeal exists on paper, but Snapdeal is not doing great, which all of us are aware of. Same thing is going to be in edutech space also. All the companies like Byju's, Vedantu's, they are trying to take and play every trick in the book. Amazon has come. Amazon is again going to make the life miserable for them. But yes, for the next 2-3 years, you will see a very tough competition in that market. That is where, again, a lot of jobs will come. When you go to any such job, go with one clear-cut thing in your head. If you get whatever is variable, you are just pure lucky. Never rely on the variables which you will get. I have seen Byju's offering 10 lakhs, right? And a lot of these schools flaunt that, you know, Byju's picked our kids at a 10 lakh package. That's a bloody sham. Let me tell you upfront. You please go and read the offer letter which is there. The offer letter says that for the first 3 or 4 months, the kids will be given a consolidated stipend of 25,000 rupees. And they have to meet the targets, and only those who meet the targets, they will be, you know, further absorbed in Byju's. Those who don't meet the target will be set tied up, bye-bye. And in that 10 lakh, if I'm not wrong, some 4 lakh rupees is a variable cost. So whenever you are thinking about that, I'm telling you, opportunities are there. There's going to be a lot of pressure and variables. I'm not very sure how many of you are going to get. Then if you talk about... FMCG companies, again, FMCG will see a good growth. So FMCG companies, even all the companies which are involved in infra, you will see a good growth over there also. That is going to be another sector where you can see FMCG, those who are involved in infra, they will see a good growth. Automobile, nothing will happen. Because automobile companies themselves don't know what is going to happen. every 10 days there is a news about, you know, electric cars, and then that there will be some subsidy by the government on electric cars, and all the major players, they have invested so much in non-electric cars that they don't realize that, I don't know what has hit from there. That is going to be another big challenge which they are going to face. Consulting firms, yes, the numbers will increase. I'm not aware whether consulting firms come to your campus or not, but consulting firms, yes, you will see the numbers will increase. The biggest reason for numbers increasing for consulting firm is that now they are getting a lot of government business. That is where bulk of their, you know, business is coming from. So that number may increase. However, given the meltdown in economy, their private sector billing has stopped quite a bit. But still, if you ask me, I will say that maybe on a, it will be on a slight bit of positive, which is there. That is another area which you can think about. Telecom is in bad shape at, as far as the numbers are concerned. Telecom, you, if they maintain the numbers like last year, that would be great. IT sector, the jobs will increase. All this automation, digitization, and one more reason why the jobs will increase in IT sector is that during this pandemic, a lot of small companies working in IT space actually folded. They couldn't survive the onslaught. They didn't have that financial bandwidth. And that is why they folded. That is why the order book of larger companies in IT space, it is swelling, a good number. That is where you can definitely expect the numbers to go up. Again, I don't know how many of them visit your campus, but if they do, you can see an increased number of hiring over there. Which sector did I miss out? Okay, if I missed out on any sector, you can ask me.
Sir, pharma?
Pharma, see, pharma will go up, but pharma will not go up actually for, you know, salespeople. Pharma will go up for those who are in engineering and technical space, R&D space. For them, it will go up. That is what my feel, because a large chunk of whatever pharma will be manufactured, now the Indian companies are looking at the opportunities to export. And when you export, you don't need the, you know, the local manpower. So the sector will grow. I cannot say whether the jobs will definitely not increase, maybe increase by a certain level, but not again a tremendous. And all pharma companies taken together, let me tell you, across all campuses, they don't give more than 300 offers. All pharma companies across all campuses don't give more than, B school campus don't give more than 300 offers. Usme bad bhi jaye to kya, ghat bhi jaye to kya, I don't know what we are going to get on this. Any other sector?
Sir, oil and gas.
See, oil and gas is largely, you know,
government departmentalized.
And after the Chennai High Court case, these companies, they cannot pick from campus. They have to pick through an All India exam. Some of them are picking. They pick them as on contract. And then over a period of time, they regularize it. But that's very far and few. And it is unless and until you know someone right up there, no one is going to bend backward to do so much for kids. That is right.
Oil and gas.
Good morning, Shubham.
Good morning. It's evening, sir.
Tell Utsav can tell you for oil and gas. Tell me. Tell him, Utsav.
Yeah, yes, we were just discussing about oil and gas only, that it is not, unless and until we know somebody very up, somebody in the company very up, they won't bend for the MBA students.
And metal and mining?
Sorry?
Metal and mining.
Online exams are important more. Campus recruitment staff for Chennai.
Campus recruitment will not happen. Metal and mining, again, I will tell you, mining will go up. Only 3 days ago, our Honorable Nitin Gadkari Sahab had issued a warning to steel companies that if you people artificially inflate the price, we will go for alternate and we will use fiber in construction. So again, that's going to be limited.
Sir, what about hospitality industry?
Go down, obviously. Hospitality, aviation, it will go down. Maybe in those who are in first year, they can look forward to a good harvest from these sectors. But those who are in second year, no, I don't think so. I think Indigo has survived. They did not make loss, if I'm not wrong. But I was speaking to Mr. K.S. Bakshi, who's their group HR head. They are not going to recruit at all. The same is for all hospitality companies. But if I tell you something, you know where your real opportunities are there. Your real opportunities are there in small firms who have come into business. And that is where startup firms are going to be a big, big, big recruiter across campuses. The irony is most of the B schools don't prepare their students for working in startups. I can tell you my example. I have a thumb rule for my company. Anyone who has worked in IT sector before MBA degree, we don't touch him or her by barge pole. IT sector is the biggest killer in India. Those who have worked in IT sector, उनकी उम्मीद एमबीए के बाद होती है कि मैं काम उतना ही करूं लेकिन पैसे मेरे बहुत बढ़ जाएं. और काम उतना ही करूं का मतलब है एसेंशियली मैं काम ना करूं और पैसे मुझे बहुत मिलते हैं. इट डज नॉट हैपन इन स्टार्टअप. यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इफ देयर इज अ स्टार्टअप विद 10 12 15 एम्प्लॉइज एवरीवन नोस एवरी डे व्हाट द अदर पर्सन इज डूइंग. इन अ लार्ज कंपनी यार बहुत दिन तक तो पता ही नहीं चलता है कि वो बंदा आया ही नहीं है. That's a reality. I was talking to, you know, the national sales head of Tata Steel. He said, you know what, this lockdown period, at times I feel bad when people say that, sir, what should I tell you? There is some family thing going on. And that is why, you know, and there is a this problem, there is that problem. They are on leave or they don't come to meeting. He said, which I empathize. But you know what I see in the evening? They are there in some mall. And he said, even if you go to mall, why do you bloody put the pictures on social media so that everyone knows that you were there in the mall having a blast? And during the day, you say that, you know what, this was the problem, this was the problem, this was the problem. So again, I'm sharing that startups, everyone knows what the other person is doing. And you cannot, you know, just decide to have, yeah, das din nahi kaam karenge fir sochenge. It does not work like that in startups. You have to be on your toes. You have to do everything yourself. There is not a support system. But that is where the future of MBA graduates in the country lies, if you ask me honestly. I think that is where I would like to end. I think, again, media can be one business where opportunities will increase. Content can be one business where opportunities will increase. And again, to go into media and content, I need not say how important your communication is. That's pretty much from my end. Any questions, I'll be happy to take.
Sir, Tanuj this side.
Yeah, Tanuj.
So, working in startups, it actually gives you experience, the real-time experience, but also the job security is always not there in the startups. Like
pretty low.
It's pretty low because if I talk about government itself, the consultancy firms or in a digital agency, like the government's cash flow is slow. It takes around 6 months to 7 months for the cash to come in, for the revenue to come in. So at times there are situations wherein the company doesn't give you salaries as well. And you don't have an option to, you know, leave or you are just stuck there. And it actually demotivates you. So after MBA also, if we are facing such issues, so that's why, you know, we feel a bit scared that if we are going in a big firm or established firm wherein our job is safe, we do the same amount of work, but we know that our job is secured there. Like the job security is better there than a startup. Like if we have worked in before, like if we have worked before MBA, we have worked in a startup and we know the real time situation. But then after MBA also, we don't want to go there. We want to have a settled life. Like we want to settle down in a big firm, like for a year, for certain years. We know that job security is there. So that's the main concern that we face after MBA. Any viewpoints?
Anuj, everyone wants to marry Aishwarya Rai or Deepika. But to marry Aishwarya or Deepika, either you have to be the son of Amitabh Bachchan or you have to be Ranveer Singh yourself. What I'm trying to share with each one of you is, there are always ideal situations and then there are practical situations. The fact of the matter remains that the number of B-school graduates which come out of B-schools every year cannot be accommodated in all these great companies which we are talking about. Right? So if you get into that, absolutely nothing like that. But the fact remains that all of you will not get into that. Then what comes next? What you have said, I do not deny that. That's a reality. But at the same time, I can give you hazar examples where people have made the money that their batchmates could only dream of. That's also a reality, right? So again, it's a simple thing. The higher the risk, higher the return. No, I don't want to take risk. It's okay. That's an individual's call. I'm not contesting anything what you said. It's all correct. I agree. And I'm not here advocating, you know, for startup firms, but I'm telling you a reality that if you get into that space, the bright side is that you can rise very fast. The dark side is what you shared. But the reality also is that over there, when you are there, you have to work because you are under observation at any point.
Yes, sir. It's not like 8 hours of job. It's like you work for 12 hours, 15 hours. It depends on the situation that you have to work.
But those are also the companies which can give you a leave only because you call up in the morning and say, sir, aaj mere ko kaam karne ka dil nahi kar, aaj chutti le lo. They will give you leave also. That is how it's always a give and take relationship.
Yes, sir.
Shubham, you have a question?
Yes, sir. So like talking about specifically of FMCG sector. So as we know that FMCG does not take freshers very frequently. Frequently, like in walk-ins. I'm talking about walk-ins, not for campus placement. So if we want to make our career in FMCG and we want to go for walk-in, so how could we do that? Can you elaborate on that?
What companies don't allow? There is nothing to elaborate. Or again, I don't know the set of companies which come to your campus. Right? And I think I gave that disclaimer 3-4 times that I don't know whether they come to your campus, whether they don't come to your campus. If they come to your campus, that is great. You also, you know, need to realize somewhere that, again, what are the options there in front of me? And how can I make the best of those options? जैसे मैं आपको सच्ची बात बताता हूं, एंड अगेन डोंट माइंड माई स्टीरियोटाइपिंग इट, ऑल द गर्ल्स हु स्टडी इन दिल्ली बी स्कूल्स, मेनी कंपनीज डोंट वांट टू टच देम. टेल मी व्हाई. आई एम टेलिंग यू अ रियलिटी. अ लॉट ऑफ एचआर हेड्स हैव कन्फेस्ड दिस टू मी. दे डोंट वांट टू टच दीज किड्स. यू नो व्हाई?
सर, बिकॉज दे डोंट वांट टू डू अ सेल्स प्रोफाइल.
इट्स नॉट ओनली अबाउट दे डोंट वांट टू डू अ सेल्स प्रोफाइल. अगर उनका नोएडा में घर है तो उन्हें गुड़गांव जाने में दिक्कत होती है. गुड़गांव में घर है तो उन्हें नोएडा ऑफिस आने में दिक्कत होती है. वेस्ट दिल्ली है तो मैं वहां कैसे जाऊं, साउथ दिल्ली है तो मैं वहां कैसे जाऊं. वो कहते हैं भाई इससे अच्छा है लखनऊ के कॉलेज से उठाओ, उसको कहीं भी फेंक दो, उसके लिए सब बढ़िया ही बढ़िया. प्लीज डोंट माइंड माई सेइंग दिस, बट दिस इज, दीज आर एग्जैक्ट रियलिटी विच द कंपनीज फेस. व्हाई वुड दे टेक सो मच ऑन देयर हेड यार? इवन फॉर कॉलेजेस लाइक IMI, आई कैन टेल यू, the HR head से इनको 1.5 साल के अंदर वापस दिल्ली में ही नौकरी चाहिए, and they will have reasons for which we have no answer. I am getting married, my father, my parent, this illness, whatever. They said, bhai, I am not contesting that, but in my scheme of things, it does not work that, you know, 20% or 25% of my workforce I will be keeping that in Delhi. My headquarters is in Mumbai. It does not fit into my scheme of things. How open we are. All of us say, no, I want to work in a, you know, Delhi. Bhai, tum Delhi mein kaam karoge, to Fatehabad mein ja karke Axis Bank ki branch kaun chalayega, mujhe ye batao. Aur tumme aisi kaun si nayab baat hai ki tumhe Delhi mein rakhu, jo 2 saal se Fatehabad mein, main use kyun na Delhi leke aun, usne kam se kam 2 saal mere saath काम तो किया, तुम में क्या ऐसी बात है? नहीं, हमें तो सर चाहिए, तो कहते हैं बेटा हम दे नहीं सकते, इसलिए तुम निकल लो. And then you will say, you know, I was not. Why should you be considered? Why? You tell me that. How have you proven yourself? See, I don't want to dissuade you people. But I'm telling you, this is the reality. Ki bahut baar hame samajh mein hi nahi aata hai. Kai baar kya hota na, I'm being upfront with you. I also blame the placement committees. I also blame the placement officers. कंपनी आई है बैठना मैंडेटरी है बिठा दिया कंपनी ने 25 बार बोल दिया सेल्स प्रोफाइल है अरे तुम बैठो तो सही और बच्चा इंटरव्यू में जाकर के उसे पूछो टेल मी समथिंग अबाउट योरसेल्फ आई डिड माय समर इंटर्नशिप इन रिक्रूटमेंट टैलेंट बेंचमार्किंग आर यू अवेयर दिस इज अ सेल्स जॉब या सर एक्चुअली आई वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर HR बट सर सेल्स भी ठीक कोई नहीं लेगा भाई कोई नहीं तुमको लेगा कहेगा यार ये नहीं इसको पहला मौका मिलेगा भाग जाएगा क्यों इसको लेना है I'm not blaming the kids alone I'm blaming the institutes also I'm being honest with you so be very clear but then let me also tell you if you make a decision you can't hold the B school or You can't hold the college responsible. Please understand that. I think John F. Kennedy very beautifully said, don't ask yourself what the country has done for you. Ask yourself what you have done for the country. Ask the same thing. Don't ask yourself what the B school has done for me. Ask yourself what you have done for B school. Hame maje pure chahiye. Usme koi kami nahi aani chahiye. Aur last mein agar naukri dil ke like... नौकरी मिली नहीं वो भी बात नहीं नौकरी दिल के लायक नहीं मिली तो ये हमारा हक है कि मुझे जितने अपशब्द आते हैं वो सारे अपशब्द में कह डस नॉट वर्क दैट वे प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड मेक योर डिसीजंस राइट फॉर एग्जांपल आई कैन टेल यू आई थिंक इट वाज ऑलमोस्ट 45 डेज अगो आई शेयर्ड एन ओपनिंग ऑफ एक्सिस बैंक विथ योर कॉलेज आई टू नो ओनली टू किड्स वेर इंटरेस्टेड सो वी डिड नॉट टेक इट फॉरवर्ड दैट्स ओके was around 4 lakhs, 4.5 lakh, including variable. So, आप लोग नहीं interested हो, but मार्च में या फ़रवरी में सोच लेना कि मुझे वो लेना है या मुझे बिना नौकरी के निकलना. Whatever time. And again, it's not about that. I am doing. My company is doing. It's the same for any other. You know, job offers which you have got. If you get into a better one, get into a better one. But always keep the last resort ki boss, maybe in March, in February, and I will do that. That's the only thing I will leave you with. Any other questions? Maybe last one or two. So if I have to create a checklist for you, what would be that checklist? My checklist for you would be develop your core competency. Please read fundamentals, yaar. Tum marketing specialization ke bhi ho, toh kya tumne first term mein core course mein finance padha tha ya nahi padha tha? Padha tha na? Toh tumhe working capital nahi pata hai, bhai toh tum MBA hone layak nahi ho. तुम्हें करंट अकाउंट सेविंग अकाउंट डीमैट अकाउंट नहीं पता है तो तुम पढ़े लिखे कहलाने योग्य नहीं हो व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट स्कीम्स व्हिच गवर्नमेंट इज कमिंग अप विद व्हाट इज प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना व्हाट इज यू नो सुकन्या योजना व्हिच इज देयर हाउ व्हाट इज अ गोल्ड लोन व्हाट इज अ रेपो रेट व्हाट इज अ रिवर्स रेपो रेट व्हाट इज जीडीपी व्हाट इज जीएनपी अगर ये आपको नहीं पता है तो आप किस तरह से जस्टिफाई करते हो I'm not going into too much technical, but don't you think these are the terms which you as an MBA student should know? That's my point. If I talk about checklist, that is point number one. My point number two is, please read anything, but read. Kuch bhi padho, online padho, kahin bhi padho, kuch bhi padho. But padho. No amount of reading is ever going to be useless. Third, work on your communication skills. And fourth, please realize this is your career and it is in your hands. Dusre ko tum gaali bhi de doge na, usse tumhara career nahi banega. It is your career, take it into your hands, decide for yourself, do it for yourself. And remember the five C's which I talked about. Can anyone tell me what are the five C's I talked? Any one of you?
Sir, they were curiosity, connectedness,
competency,
communication, and can be contextual.
So ऊपर वाला गवाह है कि मैंने आपके साथ चीजों को शेयर करने में कोई कमी नहीं छोड़ी. Right? It is something like all of us know who are fat, how to reduce our weight. ऐसा नहीं कि हमें पता नहीं है क्या करना है. लेकिन मजे की बात यह है कि हमें पता होते हुए भी हम करते नहीं और सोच लेते हैं कि यार कम हो जाए. Right? उससे ना तो मेरा आज तक वजन कम हुआ और ना आप लोगों को नौकरी लगेगी. मुझे वजन घटाने के लिए कुछ एक्सरसाइज करना होगा, आपको नौकरी लगने के लिए कुछ मेहनत करनी होगी. Right, I think Monira, you have a question.
Yes, sir. So firstly, I would like to say that it was an amazing session. And secondly, like since we are in second year, so we are mostly concentrating on the studies and then we will be concentrating on the capstone. Meanwhile, we also do part-time internships. So like if we should give weightage to the part-time internships or workshops or some certification programs, so like how should we give weightage to these programs and part-time internships?
See, Monira, I can tell you, certification ki to na India ne as a country aisi bejati kar di hai ki uske bare mein to mujhse shabd nahi nikalwao to behtar. I can tell you honestly, you know, 15 programs I did wherein I would have invited the best of industry experts you can think of from the topmost companies. And you know what was my pain point? The kids who will register, they will type in the chat box. Will we get certificate for this? Will we get certificate? Arey bhai, aap ek mujhe ye baat batao. You are interacting with me, I am interacting with you. Do you deserve a certificate for this interaction? No, but sir, there are kids who have asked for certificate for such interactions also. And there are organizations who have promised ki agar last tak rahoge to certificate milega. Are kya karna hai aise certificate ka? Tell me that. What will you do with such certificates? Is certification important? My answer is yes. But more than certification, it is what is your learning from that certification. More than live projects. Yaar, I can tell you something. I also have my friend circle. Every year I would be giving 20 live certificates when I don't even know the kid. Main uske papa ko janta hu, main uske chacha ko janta hu, main uske bhaiya ko janta hu. Yaar ek please de, main de deta hu kyunki mere unke sath taluk aata hai. But what does that certificate do any good to the kid? The answer is no. You go for live projects. I know of kids who were doing 6 live projects all at the same time and they did not do a good job in any single one of them. Usse to acha yaar 6 live project kyon kar rahe ho, ek live project karo, please give your best so that the other people feel that okay, you are doing a great job. That is how it should be and that is what your focus should be. Whatever you do, look at what your learning is, don't look at certificate. And second, whatever live projects you undertake, please deliver it. डोंट यू नॉट टेक बिकॉज क्या होगा, आप एक कंपनी में जाते हो, आपने घटिया काम भी किया ना, आप लास्ट में इमोशनल कार्ड फेंक देते हो. बट सर प्लीज दे दीजिए ना. Now, most of us feel कि यार एक बच्चे को क्या ही परेशान करो, टेल मी, हम दे देते हैं. बट डज दैट हेल्प यू एक्चुअली इन द लॉन्ग रन? व्हाट हैव यू लर्नड फ्रॉम दैट लाइफ प्रोजेक्ट? नथिंग, खत्म, इट्स ओवर, आउट, दैट्स ऑल. दैट इज व्हाट माय टेक ऑन ऑल दिस इज.
So I can just invite Soumya Ahuja. She had a question. If she is around and still she has a question, and I think that's the last question we should take.
Yeah.
Go
ahead.
So my question is, am I audible? Okay. So my question is that while we say that some jobs will be cut, it is something that has happened since time immemorial. Some jobs are cut, some jobs will be created in the market. So what we need is skill upgrade and okay, it's taken. This is something that will happen for all the times to come. But how do I identify what will be the next big thing? Are there some signs in the economy or are there some indicators or some cues which are going to help me to identify, okay, this will be the next big thing and this is something I should bank upon in, let's say, in the long run, in next 10 years, 15 years to come. So what are those signs and how can we identify them?
So I will tell you, you know, the first point which you made about, you know, the jobs are created, the jobs get over. It is a continuous process. I agree to that point. But then you also need to realize that there are inflection points in the world economy when the pace of change is much drastic than what we have witnessed earlier. I took example of 2008 because that was an inflection point. Again, COVID in 2020 was an inflection point. So what happens, and the joke going around in all the CXO circles is, neither the CEO nor the CTO drove digitization as fast as COVID drove digitization. Right? So again, I'm talking about the pace which is there. Are there signs to it? Yes, there are signs. Rajiv sir would know 1,000 times better than me that whenever we talk about economy, there are lead indicators and there are lag indicators. Right? So if you look at the lead indicators in the economy, they give you the perspective. If you look at lead indicators within the industry, that also gives you. For example, all of you talked about a lot of sectors. We didn't talk about agriculture sector, right? Why? Because we have seen over a period of time that the contribution of agriculture to our GDP has not increased beyond a certain point. Now, if there is a sector whose contribution to GDP is increasing at a great pace, that is a sector to watch out for. Please read the relevant industry news, be in touch with that. You will realize how things are moving. When I talked about startup, let me tell you why India is betting on that. It will be a very interesting read if you go and read about startup ecosystem in US. A large chunk of their GDP growth is contributed by the startups. And that is what India is trying to achieve. Because with, you know, your traditional companies, that is only a certain level to which your GDP can increase. So that is my answer to your point. One, inflection point. And two, I said that there are lead indicators. You need to identify, you read the news, you will get that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I think, Mr. Subrat, thank you for every input that you have shared with the students and the kind of questions and the interest. I think I was not very sure that so many would be joining. And of course, this was one of the first kind of interactions that we were conducting. And the second thing that out of my own experience and what I also prefer is seeing the young energetic faces live. So we made it very clear that everyone has to be seen in the camera. So still I find that after about 75 minutes, they continue to be there. This means that, yes, there has been some valuable input and they have enjoyed the session. So thank you for that. And students, if you have a set of questions still to be answered, I think the way we can do it, Subhraji, is that we'll have these questions collated and then we can have another session sometime, something similar, so that we have a very focused kind of a interaction in case, and even if it is a short or even a long interaction, we can do it. And that's when we will request you once again to be here.
For the last 10 years, I have not said no to you. I will never say no to you. You know that, sir.
I'm very much obliged and my gratitude to you, despite all your busy schedule at a very short notice. Even today, you have agreed to be here. So I would hand over back to Kalpana, and you may please take it to the conclusion. So is Kalpana Pandey there? I can't see you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so please take it forward. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Today, in the times of pandemic, we might not be able to establish a physical connect
but we surely would like to acknowledge the effort made to enlighten us all. Sir, please accept the virtual memento on behalf of the entire team of Delhi School of Business, WIPS TC.
Thank you.
I think we can give a round of applause and thank you, at least.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
I further express my extensive gratitude to all the participants and members present today, and again thank each one of you for your gracious presence here in making the Crossroads Talk a successful one. Thank you once again to each one of you.
So, shall we conclude? We leave?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Professor Subrat. Thank you, all the members in the faculty. And of course, thank you, my dear friends. And for actually, this talk was meant for you. And of course, we were also benefited by a lot of information that he has shared. And we'll continue to carry forward this talk series, which we very quickly coined as Crossroad Talk Series, because we find that each one of us at every age, and particularly you, must be finding yourself at some crossroads where you have to make a choice for your future, a choice for your career. And if these talks can in any ways help, it will be a big contribution. It will be a big help from our side. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you, sir.